guys, it's your boy Chris, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool Chrome of where last time left off. We saw, Sadio Mane is going to be a very key figure for in his duration at this club throughout this career mode. Because, was he impressive! Like, he was on fire. Yeah. Unfortunately, a cup match has come, so he has to take his rest. But I am going to be keeping my eye on Daniel Sturridge and Danny Ings because Divock Origi's goal scoring record of 1 goal and 5 league games isn't the best. I know a lot of it is down to Sadio Mane being so awesome, but that shouldn't take away from Divock Origi's natural brilliant skill for himself. So Daniel Sturridge and Danny Ings aren't essentially going to be competing with Divock Origi for that second striker slot in this match. Well, in this episode. These two are going to have their opportunity in this match, and at the weekend when I play Hull, both Divock Origi will get what may be his last chance to keep his starting, well, it will be his last chance to keep his starting place. If I feel that Daniel Sturridge or Danny Ings impressed more than he did, then come the game after Hull, they will find themselves in the starting lineup.
Behind the other,
now, of course, Divock Origi and Sadio Mane here are sitting on the bench. If Daniel Sturridge and Danny Ings aren't enough to beat the Hammers, who aren't having a good start to this season, to say the very least. And Slaven Village is not a very happy man at the moment.
Winston Reid starts, looking to continue his good form at the back. Andre Ayew starts with
wide positions. Andy Carroll. They may have Dimitri Payet, but even he can't seem to get him out of this little slump that they're currently in. And in real life. So, yeah. And in game, they're probably hoping that it doesn't come to point where he bring up Sadio Mane. Let's just leave it at that, shall we? Next, Arnold! Oh, what a start that would have been. Pulling off a great save. Leon Englishman. Poor clearance from Payet. Oh, poor clearance from Payet almost resulted in Thiago Llori getting a goal. Great save from Adrian and save Payet's backside. And a poor touch results in a West Ham goal kick. Blue lights on at Anfield.
It will be pretty wet after 5 minutes.
Yes, this is the second cup tie of the season, so this is in real life. Liverpool, we played Derby. I almost said Burton, but that was the game that we were playing, that in reverse we played Spurs. So be a bit wary if our next tie is like Derby and then it's Burton. Because would that mean if we get past Spurs, we get West Ham? Because they are still in the cup, despite it Akron's and Stanley's best efforts.
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
It almost seemed to be that West Ham almost didn't get past Accrington Stanley.
Andre Ayew.
It took him to the, I think it was like the 96th minute or something like that when they scored. So, that tells you West Ham not having a good season. Not at all. You can see my new youthful goalkeeper. If goalkeeper is in goal again, he made his brief debut in the last episode when I brought him on pretty much to give the kick out to end the game in my match against Leicester. Oh yes! Adrian makes a huge mistake and it's a goal on his debut for the Hood! What a mistake by Adrian! Actually, that might go down as an own goal. Because he just wanders back into the net. He catches it. No bother. But decides, you know what? We'll walk into the goal. And as it is, an own goal by Adrian. Great header by the Hood. I just noticed that it gave him the number 8. Earn that shirt, boy. Oh yeah, I don't care for if we do sign you in real life or not. If you're gonna wear the number 8, you're gonna earn it.
Maybe the cross.
There's Gruitch. Sturridge. Daniel Sturridge! Not the best shot. Considering his header to score the opening goal. That is a far cry from that, to say the very least. Oh, but a mistake by Adrian, another one! And Sturridge scores it in! Adrian is having an absolute shocker. It's another short kick from the computer, and they are absolutely made to pay. By me. I mean, when the computer offers you a gift, you just gotta take it and say thank you very much. The score will be changing now. Thank you very much. Oh my god. And here I was, because it hadn't happened in a while, so I was like thinking, oh, maybe they've stopped doing it. Nope. Nope. That is not the case at all.
Well, this is delightful.
Well, it's 3-0. Daniel Sturridge brace here, sandwiching that Adrian Howler, a double Adrian Howler for goals 2 and 3. He, like I said, not having his best game in a West Ham shirt. And he is a fantastic goalkeeper, but not having a great game.
But not yet. Well, with the confidence he's displayed, I was fully expecting the...
Our man, Daniel Sturridge, he is. He is definitely having a great game. Not making the same mistake this time. He's kicking it long, but it was won by Ragnar Klavan. His Ings. Shea Ojo. Who doesn't win the ball, but it's come to Calabria. Alexander Arnold. Flips it in. Dangs! Can't keep it in. Did he win the corner?
It is a criticism of.
Yeah, he did. There's a. Dimitri Payet. Only one touch, which almost cost West Ham a goal. Oh, and Thiago already had his shot. Saved by. Which was saved by. Adrian had a pull off another great save. I think that was Danny Ings with the header. Yeah, sure, there was. I recognize that. It's a facial hair and her unique hairstyle and facial hair combo on any player, plus 28 on his shorts is a dead giveaway of who it is.
Sheku Kuyate.
Carroll is not going to want to remember this game so far against his former club.
Well, I guess he was aiming for a teammate, but he certainly didn't.
Dmitry Payet might not want to remember this game either, although I think that it's not going to be on top of West Ham's favorite game list, and it's not getting any better. Alexander Arnold has won through absolutely tons of players and has absolutely made a mockery of the defense. And Winston Reid, where is he going?
Here is another angle on that goal.
Now, yeah. Defensive calamities, goalkeeper calamities. Whew, it is not getting any better to be a West Ham fan right now. I don't even know how they're doing in the league in the game, but this was like if boy would West Ham fans want to bury their heads in the nearest the sand. No sign of Derby or Burton, so I don't know if I can get them. Only one standout name there. I mean, there are standout names there, like Southampton, Swansea, and Watford, and stuff like that. But Man United are still there. I know that's not all the games. Obviously, I assume that's not all the games. Marky Noble. Yeah, I'm sure he'll make a huge difference. Although, he has done it before against Liverpool, unfortunately. His chicken dance is probably forever etched into my brain. Man, I wish I could do that celebration just to rub this in now.
We've seen Alan, but it's extraordinary. It's gone the other way.
I mean, it wouldn't matter if it was on the game. I would probably not know how to do it. It probably is on the game. I just don't know how to do it. Although I've never seen anyone do it, so.
He's given possession away here.
Dude. Gomez. Ooh. Sold that pass short, but Clavin mopped up the slight miss. The West Ham players didn't capitalize. Cross in. Sturridge wasn't in the position he should have been in. It's a better pass from Gomez to Shea Ojo.
Cross. That's not a good cross at all.
Cross left something to be desired. Grealish going for glory. Gomez.
Good strong tackle.
Inks. Grealish. Dahoud.
This is a good opportunity to put the ball into the penalty area now.
Wins a corner.
In the middle to stop the cross like that.
Off 22, Sam Byram, if I'm not mistaken, is a 22 for West Ham.
Well, that's good support.
Here's Ings.
Here comes the cross.
Daniel Sturridge! Oh, he is going for the spectacular now. Oh.
Yeah, it was a decent stop. You'd expect.
Oh, he is gonna try everything to get that hat trick, which is even these two goals. Even two goals is putting a lot of pressure on he Volkerigi. Oh, Alexander Arnold, Whoops it. And it's going to come to the storage. Is he going to be able to keep it in? Just.
Well, the ball deserved perhaps a better response from his teammates. Than the
oh. The another defensive clown. He. No. And I think it's Kayute who can't keep it in. So Gouli's coming on for Ayu. Who, not really much Ayu can do to improve. Near Ayu or Fuguli, I don't think could improve this, to be honest. It's a poor attempt from Alexander Arnold, considering his earlier attempt was so fantastic. Yeah, you'd be forgiven for forgetting I am, what, a 16-year-old kid who's starting his first ever professional match at goal? Well, there are like any shots, he might be a bit shaky. He doesn't have to deal with any shots. I don't think West Ham have been anywhere near my goal. Daniel Sturridge for the hat-trick! Oh, he's at the bar again! Oh! Daniel Sturridge is not getting any luck when it comes to this hat-trick goal. Oh, it's come to Joe Gomez! Oh! I thought he might spill it.
4-0 here, and almost time up.
Alexander-Arnold, Bridge, Sturridge.
City in the next one.
How much pressure is he going to put on Origi? Skied it this time. He's not had a good second half compared to his first half.
Daniel Sturridge.
Although, that would all change with him scoring the hat-trick goal.
Promising build-up.
Referee? No? Really?
There's only a minute to go.
Well, it doesn't matter. There's the full-time whistle. West Ham are put out of their misery. And it was indeed misery. Look at that. Calabria went 8. That's very good. Good. You want to impress me, friend, and you're going about it the right way. You're going about getting yourself a damn contract. Look at that. 7.1 was my loss. It was my keeper who did. I don't even think he touched the ball. That's how poor West Ham were. Let's see. I look like they've won. Plymouth have won. Bournemouth have won. Southampton are in extra time. And Swansea have won.
West Ham United, 0. Norwich City, 1. Manchester United, 2.
You're very welcome, dude.
Reading, 1.
What was that up in the top 2. Front? It was like an overhaul or something. Whatever that was, I'm not sure I kind of missed it. Portugal, nope. Actually, wait, I don't respond to these anymore. Almost completely forgot. If things are going well, I might be able to get another few junk minutes from my up-and-coming keeper. Because his rating needs to go up faster. Or if he's going to have any serious hope of one day being the replacement for Karius. Although I had 2 goalkeepers in last season. That's FIFA, and didn't really need him. I mean, it was good to have both, but very little need for him.
Hi there, a Premier League game for you today. I'm Martin Tyler. And to call the action,
all I need is a bit of a repeat from real life or We won this fixture 5-1.
When you played here, Alan, did you touch that Anfield sign on the way out, or was that only for the home team?
That is strictly only for the home team, Martin.
Few differences from the side that played that day. He, namely, he, Sewell, Alaba, Chan didn't play that game. Him. And Origi. Well, Chan and Origi didn't start the game, they came on after the... No, wait, I'm thinking of the Swansea game. Did Chan and Origi come on?
James Milner starts.
I think they did they?
Strike force, Sadio Mane.
No, I think Daniel Sturridge came on in that match.
We've got the whole City team here for you. Alan McGregor plays in goal. Curtis Davis starts with Michael Dawson in central defence. Jake Livermore plays with David Myler in central midfield.
This was a few weeks ago now.
Just one up front. David Myler.
Well, I'm not going to lie.
Shots off!
That's a big... Oof! Almost a fantastic start for Hull. That would have been a great way to get any nerves that they might have out of their head. Although there's one player on my team who might want to be nervous. He needs to have a very good game. And that's Mr. Origi.
Top defending this season. You have to hand it to Liverpool.
Well, defending is an art.
Let's see more of D-Lock.
This lot haven't forgotten him, that's for sure.
I believe you're going to be a fantastic player, but I need to see that you're going to be in your brain now. I mean, Daniel Sturridge is sitting there. You're probably thinking, how did I score 2 goals and get left on the bench?
Keep it down. No, never really threatened to...
Joel Matip trying to open the goal score for this game. No success, but he gets an A for effort because it's a fantastic effort, despite not getting the result of a goal. Firmino, Milner, who scored 2 penalties against Hull.
That's a great finish for the first goal of the day.
And he's scored against them in FIFA as well. Oh, James.
I love to see that. Don't have to whack it from that kind of position.
There's lots at home. Bottom corner. My avatar celebrates, the players on the bench celebrate 3 goals for James Milner now.
So the first goal, it's 1-0. Alan McAnally's at the Britannia Stadium today.
I think that puts him as the second top goal scorer, at least from me. Anyway.
The keeper trying to play sweeper completely missed his clearance and gave his opponents an open goal. 19 minutes played, 1-0.
Cheers, Alan.
Origi. Good ball to Emery Chan. And get up, Emery, come on.
Nice return pass. Well, the host club today are just on fire. They've won their last 5 games. If they can turn it into 6, well, they'll be thumbing through the record books to see when it last happened.
I'm sure the crowd here.
Firmino.
The players can't afford to.
Could be. A good chance here. Firmino! He went to give it to Origi. Origi didn't hit it. So it came to Zion, man. And the pace and the angle just didn't work for him. Goal number 12 did not come there for Zion, man. Who didn't score against Hull in real life? No, wait, yes he did. I'm thinking of someone. I'm thinking of Swansea he didn't score.
Chance to get some width.
Manny got the third goal.
with some danger. He's better usually at crossing that. It was a defender who got there first quite easily, actually. Crisp defending there. Robertson.
Oh, Origi, give him the present. Will he score? Oh!
That's a corner now for Liverpool.
Good save, forced by Origi. Alaba trying to hit and falling over in the process.
But it's a pretty slender margin at this stage. We've got half time.
Daniel Klein is going to.
He's still intact.
Keep the defense.
Roberto Firmino.
As should be.
On the injury front from Jeff Shreves.
There's a. Another attack. Looks like he's gonna be okay. Firmino trying to win the corner, wins a throw instead.
That's a wasted throw. He's giving it straight to
there's
the opposition.
Alaba.
And the cross is in.
Looking for Origi! Off the crossbar! Oh! At least tell me that's a corner.
Well, I don't think the keeper could have got to that, so he was thankful that the crossbar was in the way.
How unlucky can Divock Origi get? Manny? Whoops in! Matip! 2-0! Joe Matip! He didn't get the ball earlier, but he gets it this time. It's another assist for Alaba. It's a fantastic, towering header from the counter. It's probably not right at all. And it's his first goal in the Premier League. Oh, wait, it's scored. Just need to check something. You know? He must have walked it off. Gabe just told me Alaba was injured. That's why I paused it to check that. But he's not got the simpleness, so. Maybe it was when he fell over in the box earlier when he tried to knock in Firmino's cross. And he tripped over the defender. Well, he ran it off anyway, so it must not have been anything. Hopefully it wasn't anything.
And that will be Liverpool's throw-in.
Lumped clear. Firmino. Aw, man, if I only had handballs on. That's ironic, because that's how Liverpool got the first penalty against Hull, is a handball. Hull?
They've worked this attack very well.
It's Coutinho who scored a very good goal against Hull.
Lay it off to the supporting player.
Go for similarity! Oh! Although, his was into the top corner. It was from roughly about that distance. Like, Sadio Mane, he's like, oh shit!
Well, that looked promising, but he's been stopped.
Great tackle by Nicholas. And great interception by Roberto. Philip Coutinho. What's the Roberto for Neil King?
Talking about this one, looking forward to it.
Origi trying to cause a mistake, but not with dice. But it's Coutinho. Alaba! Not this time. Hang on, I'm going to check something. Let's see how it has read. Divock Origi 6.9. It's not very good. Change incoming. Chen is actually really tired. Is he tired? Must be running his ass off. I want. Firmino needs it. Firmino needs a substitution, so Gini Wijnaldum is going to come on in that situation. And Chan is going to have to play out the rest of the game, unless he gets injured, which would force me to use that last substitution that I don't really need yet. Firmino! Oh, what a goal! Oh, Roberto Firmino, just as he's getting ready to go off, he leaves with an absolute spectacular goal.
Well, they've increased their lead here, and that could just wrap up the match.
Yeah, Inadvertent 1-2, or I think it was with Emre Can. Tino passes to his buddy Firmino, and Firmino rockets it into the goal. Oh. Hull fans are in shock. Firmino is delighted. With his neck tattoo. Going off. As he's getting ready to go off. And be replaced by Gini Wijnaldum. Diego Origi. You had your chance, mate.
Yes, certainly covered the ground, hasn't he? Getting forward.
Let's see how Daniel Sturridge's ring is probably going to be utter rubbish. But overall, I think Daniel Sturridge might have gotten himself into the starting lineup for the Swansea game.
Emre
Can.
And he could get away.
Wijnaldum! What an introduction this would be! Sadio Mane! He's done it again! He has, of course, done it again. Sadio Mane, he wouldn't go again. He's not going to let a game go by where he doesn't score. Great cross from Gini Wijnaldum, who gets an assist mere minutes after coming onto the pitch. And Sadio Mane, he scores one of the easiest goals he scores all season. Although, he scored a few good goals in the other 11, so I guess it's fair to let him have one easy one.
It's turning out to be a comfortable game this.
And yeah.
Nothing so far in this game to surprise us. Perhaps only
from
the
being relatively quiet, actually. His form as a lift. He finally gets involved.
What about Hull City's next game?
I guess he finally woke up. Oh, he can have an off game. That's fine by me. As long as it's not a regular occurrence.
The keeper had no chances. The ball was fired past him from 20 yards. 7-8,
which I know it's not because he's been fantastic. In game, oh, great save by Kerr. Yes. And their attempts to get the ball, they accidentally gave Hull a throw.
Seems as though it's for tactical reasons. Shots on here.
Ooh.
We're down now to the last 6 minutes.
Sewell for Clyde.
It goes out wide again.
Wijnaldum. Daniel Sturridge. Sturridge? Daniel Sturridge! Oh! That would have definitely sealed it. Not the match. The match is over. That would have definitely sealed Sturridge's place in the starting 11. He did win the corner. Miller! Oh, what would be the odds? What would be the frickin' odds? It's of James Milner scoring twice again against Hull. You'd be sick of the sight.
This period of play to add on 3 minutes.
Oh, poor pass there by Nathaniel Klein. He's had a relatively average game. It didn't matter in the end. Oh, I forgot to bring on, shit. I forgot to make my substitution. Oh, well. It'll have to happen in future games. Although, yeah, better second half, apparently. He got up to a 7.6. Roberto Firmino was man of the match with 9.4. Sturridge at a 6.2. Ooh, he was only on for about half an hour. Not even half an hour. Actually, well, with the added time, he would have been on for half an hour. So, and he's definitely going to start against Swansea.
Arsenal 1, Chelsea 2, Bournemouth 2, Everton 2.
So, yeah.
Hull City 0. Manchester United.
What does that mean? Well, it means Diogo Origi is out of the starting 11, and Daniel Sturridge is in.
Crystal Palace 0. Swansea City 2, Manchester City 2. So what do those results mean to the...
There's the change confirmed. So don't forget to do it. Because I know me, I would.
In third, Manchester City with 12 points. In fifth, Stoke City with...
Oh, you don't understand how... Oh, much I don't give a shit about your playing time. You can rot on the bench, you piece of shit. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. That's a fantastic minute. And before we say peace, until next time, you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.
Albion with 4 points. Fifth bottom, Leicester City with 5 points.